Have you ever wanted to look up into the night sky and see the stars, but it's the middle of the day? Or you're inside, or you live somewhere where it's hard to see the stars at night because of city lights or cloudy weather? These same problems also come up for astronomers who are studying space. Thankfully, we can build models to help us study things that might otherwise be hard to see. When it comes to modeling the sky, planetariums are a great tool to help us learn. Hi, my name is Mary, and I'm a video producer with the digital learning team here at the Pacific Science Center. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to use one of the same tools that our team uses to explore outer space with our virtual learners. Stellarium is a free planetarium program that uses real data to model the sky and expands opportunities to make astronomy observations. Stellarium is available for Mac and PC and also has a mobile app and web browser version available. Follow the link I've included in the description to learn more about how you can install Stellarium. When you first open Stellarium, you'll see the sky with some default settings, as well as a couple of menus. If you hover your mouse over the left-hand side of the window, a menu will appear with the following options. Location window. Clicking on this opens a window where you can select the location that you're viewing the sky from. You can choose to view the sky from your current location or from anywhere around the world. Date and time window. This allows you to adjust the date and time for when you're viewing the sky. Sky and viewing options. This allows you to make several adjustments for how different features will appear. For example, you can use the Sky Cultures tab to view and learn about constellations from different cultures. The search window allows you to search for a specific object in the sky. The Astronomical Calculations window allows you to access more data about the locations and movements of different celestial bodies. And finally, the Help icon gives you an in-depth key command guide, as well as links to some other resources for how you can use Stellarium. If you move your mouse over the left-hand side of the bottom of the program window, another helpful menu will appear. This one has a number of helpful tools for when it comes to viewing the sky. Firstly, you can toggle the cardinal directions by pressing this button or by clicking the Q key on your keyboard. This will reveal the directions on the horizon side and help you with navigating the sky. You can change the time displayed either with the date and time window or by using these keys to adjust the passing of time. Selecting the increased time speed or by pressing the L key on your keyboard will speed up how quickly time is passing in the program. The more you click it, the faster time will go. To bring time back to its normal rate, you can either click this button or hit the K key on your keyboard. You can also reverse the passing of time with the decrease time speed button. Again, the more you click on it, the faster time will progress. Adjusting the time of observation is a helpful tool if you're studying phenomena such as the seasonal changes in sunlight or the moon phase cycle. If we adjust time to bring up the nighttime sky, it might be nice to look for some constellations. Now, I personally don't have a lot of experience looking for constellations, so I find it really helpful to turn on the lines for constellations, revealing their patterns in the sky. To do this, simply click on the first button on that lower left-hand side of the menu, or click on the C key on your keyboard. The constellations that you see will be whichever ones you've selected from the Sky Cultures tab in the Sky and Viewing Options window. Now that we can see our constellations, another really helpful tool is to be able to see their names. You can toggle constellation labels by clicking on the Constellation Labels button. Constellations often feature important cultural objects or figures, which can be represented with illustrations. To see artwork of what a constellation might represent, click on the Constellation Artwork button or press the R key on your keyboard. Now, I've been talking a lot about constellations, but there's so much more that you can do with Stellarium. You can find planets in the sky by using the Planets Label button or by pressing Alt-P on your keyboard. The Deep Skies Object button can be used to reveal labels for different objects, such as star clusters, nebulas, and galaxies. You can also click on any point on the screen to get more information about the specific object that you're looking at. Then you can left-click on the screen to hide that information. You can also zoom in and out by using the scroll wheel on your mouse. This allows you to make closer observations that you otherwise might not be able to without a special tool like a telescope. It's also great for pretending you're going into hyperspace. Now that we've covered some of the basics of the program, it's your time to explore the sky. In the description, I have linked a scavenger hunt that you can use to test your Stellarium skills. So have fun discovering everything that it has to offer to support astronomers of every experience level. To learn more about science programming at the Pacific Science Center, be sure to visit us at pacificsciencecenter.org. See you next time!